in our workplace, many a times we need to take a decision based on certain conditions. Like if A happens, take step X, and if B happens, take step Y, etc. That means our decision depends on certain conditions. To put it in simple, here is an example that I mentioned, I'll quote you, and I'll work on those that example. So here we have a group of employees and their basic pay and their location where they work. And when an allowance is to be paid, allowance is paid depending on their location. So here we have a condition for paying of allowance. So allowance, if employee works in a rural area, he get an allowance of 10%. If he works in an urban area, he get allowance of 20% on his basic pay. So if we have to calculate the allowance manually, then what we do is equals to Frank, and he is working in urban area, so this is his basic pay multiplied by, as he is working in urban area, we go to urban and check for urban, it is 20%. So click on this. So similarly, and second employee Ronald, then basic pay, so equals to basic pay into location is urban, so click 20% in urban here. So this is how we calculate manually. But if you have a huge data, then calculating this is manually is very difficult. So how is it we are going to calculate? That is allowance based on conditions. So in any situation where you come across a decision making based on A or B, that is if true is false or if condition 1 and condition 2. So in Excel, we have a excellent feature, that is if function. So with the help of if function, we can calculate this. So we'll see how an if function works. So equal to if. Now when you click on if, first thing is it asks you for a logical test. So logical test in the sense, what is it you want to assess? So here we have a location and we want to check location whether it is a rural or urban. So based on the logical test, if it is true, what we do? So it is equals to if our logical test is, so our location, select the location. So if logical test equals location equals to rural, as rural is in text format, put this in a double quote. So select rural or type rural. So we are putting a condition, C is the location, if location equals to rural. Okay, now if value is true, if this is true, what is it we want is, we want to calculate basic pay into allowance. So basic pay is, here we have a basic pay, select this cell and multiplied by allowance to be paid in a rural area and make this constant by clicking function key F4, comma, if it is false. So in this case it is not urban, it is, so it is not rural, urban. So if it is false, then what we have to do is select this into, if it is not rural, automatically it means it is urban. So click on urban and click function key F4 to make this constant, and click OK and click enter here. So here you got the value and we check. So this equals to basic pay into urban. So 23825. Now drag this down. If you look at Johnson, he works in a rural area and his basic pay is 96,445. So here this equals to 96,000 into, so 9,645. Now what is that we have done here is, if you look at a formula bar, what we are doing is we are giving a logical test, that is our location, whether location equals to, whether it is a rural area, we are making a condition. If this is true, then basic pay into 10% of allowance. If it is false, mean automatically you have a second option, that is urban. And so we calculated for urban. So this is how we use if condition in calculating allowances, or when we have a conditional calculations to be performed. Now we take another example. Now here we have only two, that is a rural area is a one and urban is another one. But what happens, suppose you have a semi-urban. Have a semi-urban location, and in case of a semi-urban location, the incentive that or the allowance is 15%. So we calculate this allowance again, and we make a small change in the locations. So any individual who is earning more than 80,000, we put them into semi-urban. So now we have a three categories: urban, semi-urban and rural. Now equals to, if a logical operator, we need to look at a location. If location equals to rural, if location equals to rural, what is that we want? Basic pay multiplied by allowance paid in a rural area. Click function key F4 to make this constant. So this is done. But here it is asking, we have only another input, that is if it is false. But here we have a two different options, that is urban and semi-urban. So what is it we can do is, so one, we have a if condition here. If it is a false, we go for second if condition. That is called another, we write another if equals to if, open a bracket, then logical test again, if location equals to urban, location equals to urban, then basic pay into allowance at urban 20%. So click F4 to make this constant. Now we have two conditions, one is for a rural area and another is for a urban. And again we have another one here, value if false. So if false, then basic pay into semi-urban, and make this constant by clicking F4. Now if you observe here, the semi-urban, earlier it is 19,000, now it is 14 because he has paid 15%. So here what is it we have done is, first we wrote one if condition, and after one condition is met, second we wrote another if condition. So this what we call as nested ifs. So like this we can write up to 64 if conditions within one if condition. So nested ifs, we can write the maximum of 64 if conditions. Now similarly, if semi-urban is here and if you add a metro, and in the case of metro, allowance paid is 25. Now we make anyone who is making above 1,20,000, we put them as a metro. So here we have a two categories metro. So in all we have four different categories: rural, urban, semi-urban and metro. So we look at a more broader if equals to if, that is our location, if this equals to rural, then basic pay into allowance paid in a rural area, make this constant, and next. So one more condition equals to if location equals to semi-urban. We are writing this in double quotes because it's in a text. Then basic pay into what is allowance paid in a semi-urban, 15%. Then finally, again one more if condition, if location equals to urban, then basic pay into urban, and finally basic pay into allowance paid in a metro area. So once you have coded, just check that how many number of, so if you observe, so this is in the same color. So brackets of third if condition is in same color, and put a second if condition. So this here is a second if and third bracket. So first and third and black. So we close as number of open brackets we have. We have a number of closed brackets also, and click OK. So this is how we go on adding nested ifs as many as we can, and the limit is up to 64 nested if conditions.